बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास प्रोग्राम ऑफ वैशाली सेकेंडरी स्कूल बनानी कॉरपोरेशन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू आर स्टेइंग एट होम एंड ऑल ऑफ यू आर सेफ फ्रॉम COVID-19। Dear students, today I welcome all of you to my English class. Today I am going to discuss English second paper. This class is applicable for the students of class 9 and 10. Our today's topic is linking word, connector or linkers. Dear students, look at the board. Read the following sentences. There are two sentences on the board. Rohit goes to school, and another sentence is Korean goes to school. We can combine those two sentences in one sentence. Rohit and Korean go to school. These two sentences are connected or combined through AND. So, dear students, our today's lesson is connectors, linkers or linking words. Learning outcomes of this class, by the end of this class, you will be able to connect two or more words, clauses or sentences, shorten a long text, use connectors while speaking. So dear students, first of all we should know what is connector or linking word or linker. Listen to me. A word or phrase which is used to connect or link two or more words, phrases, clauses or sentences is called connector, linker or linking word. Is it clear to you? Dear students, if you have any question, you will write your question in the comment box and I will reply to your question. Next, which words are used as connector, linker or linking word? Dear students, coordinating conjunction, correlative conjunction, subordinating conjunction, relative pronoun, relative adverb, preposition, prepositional phrase, conjunctional phrase, all these are used as connector, linker or linking word. So dear students, I will discuss this one after another. First of all, I shall discuss coordinating conjunction. Coordinating conjunction. Look at the board. There is an interesting idea about coordinating conjunction. To remember the coordinating conjunctions, dear students, all of you will remember two words, hen, boys. Here, H is for, and A for and, N for the, B for but, O for or otherwise, yet is, Y is for yet, and S for so. So the coordinating conjunctions are for and now, but or otherwise, yet so. Dear students, first of all, we will see the usage of for. For is used to show reason of any action. For is used to show the reason of any action. Example, Rakib could not go to school yesterday for he was ill. Rakib was unable to go to school and its reason was his illness. And these two sentences have been connected by for. Hannah will not buy the car for she has no money. For she has no money. That means Hannah has no money. For this, she will not buy the car. So, dear students, I think all of you have understood the usage of for. Next, usage of and. And is used to link between two words or sentences of same category. Example, Rakib and Sakib read in class 10. There are two nouns, Rakib and Sakib. Rakib and Sakib, they are two nouns and they are the two words of the same category and they are linked by using and. My father is a doctor. It's a sentence. And another sentence of the same category is my mother is a teacher. So two sentences of same category are connected by using and. Have you understood? Dear students, if you find any problem, you must ask me. You have an option to ask me in the comment box. All of you must ask me. Next, usage of nor. Nor is used to introduce further negative statement. Example, not a man nor a tree is seen in the winter morning. I like neither tea nor coffee. We may say these sentences separately. A man is not seen, a tree is not seen in the winter morning. These two sentences have been combined through using nor. Not a man, nor a tree is seen in the winter morning. And I do not like tea. It's a sentence. Another sentence, I do not like coffee. Also, these two sentences have been connected as I like neither tea nor coffee. So, all of you must try to write this type of sentences using neither nor. Usage of but. But is used to show contrast or contradiction. Example, Mr. Rahul is poor but honest. There is a contradiction in this sentence. Mr. Rahul is poor but he is honest. Honest is a word of positive thought, but poor is a word of negative thought. There is a contrast between these two words. He works hard. It's a positive idea. but he earns a little amount of money, it's a negative idea. It has a negative thought. So there is also a contradiction or contrast between the two parts of the sentence. So dear students, in this way all of you will use but while writing, speaking and others. Usage of or otherwise. Or otherwise is used to link between alternatives such as do or die. There are two alternatives, do or die. Read attentively, otherwise you will fail the examination. There is also two alternatives, to read attentively or to fail in the examination. There are two alternatives, and those two alternatives are linked by using the connector or and otherwise. Usage of yet. Yet is used to show emphasis. The old man died of starvation, yet he did not beg. The old man starved, yet he did not beg. Rana became injured, yet he played for the team. Rana became injured, yet he played for the school team. I think the usage of yet is clear to all of you. Next, I will discuss the usage of so. So is used to show the result of any incident or action, such as I lost my cell phone, so I found you with my brother's phone. I lost my cell phone, it's an incident. There is an action of losing. So is a coordinating conjunction which has helped us to describe the next result of losing my cell phone. And the result is I found you with my brother's phone. So dear students, in this class we have learned what is connector, which words are used as connector, and from the first serial I have discussed the usage of coordinating conjunction. We have come to learn that the coordinating conjunctions are for, and, nor, but, or otherwise, yet, so. To remember all these coordinating conjunctions, I have uttered two words, them, boys. F is used for, A for and, N for not, B for but, O for or otherwise, Y for yet, and S for so. I have discussed the usage of these coordinating conjunctions with examples. In spite of discussing these conjunctions in details with example, if you have any problem or complexity in understanding my lecture, all of you will throw a question in the comment box and I will reply to all of your questions. Dear students, next day I will discuss correlative conjunction and subordinating conjunction. That means the usage of subordinating conjunctions and correlative conjunctions. All of you will attend my next class, and today I thank all of you from the core of my heart for attending this online class. Dear students, thanks to all again. Allah Hafiz.